Good morning, friends. It is Michael with Hello Cupcake. It is me. So, I've been asking you all to do, or to send me some questions, and I would do a Q&A. So, I happened to get some, and so let's jump right into it. So this is going to help you know a little bit more about me. The very first one, where did you grow up? Okay, so I am a SoCal boy, and I actually grew up in this little town called Desert Shores, which is located 75 miles south of Palm Springs, next to California's largest lake called the Salton Sea. And, so I was born out there in 1981, March 16th, 1981, and that's where I grew up at, basically from the time that I was born to September 1989, and my parents got divorced in like 89-90, and... No, my parents got divorced in, like, then I moved to, Beaumont, California, and I lived there for a little while until I was 16, and then I moved back to Desert Shores, and that's where I, finished out going to school and stuff. So, yeah, do I have any pets? So, as some of you do or don't know, if you're new to my channel or whatever, I do have a couple of pets. I have two cats. I have Scrappy, which is an older Maine Coon. She's about 20 years old. And I have Bella, who is about 7 or 8 years old. And I don't know what kind of breed she is, but she's been the most awesome cat I've ever owned. Even though I've had Scrappy the longest... me and Scrappy just really never connected all that much, and except for right before I went into the hospital, we connected a little bit and all that other stuff, but that's in a previous video, so yeah. Do I have any siblings? Well, you hear me talk about my sister from time to time, so yeah, I actually have two siblings. My sister and then my brother, who is my stepbrother, but we don't see each other as stepbrothers, our step-siblings or whatever. And so I have my sister Tanya, and she's the one that's going through stage 2 breast cancer right now. And I have my brother Josh, who is who lives here in Washington also. And he is a construction worker, and my sister, she owned her own business up until the time that she found out that she had cancer, and she ended up losing it due to health reasons, of course. So, yeah, that's my brothers. Now, I have other adopted siblings that, you know, this is my brother or whatever, but we have absolutely no relation whatsoever. But, yeah, those are my two. Let's see, what's the next one? Oh, what phone do I have? So, I'm actually, like, one of these lame people that has the most recent technology that was, like, 5 years ago. So, my phone is a Samsung Galaxy 5. Yeah. Can't complain about it. I really love the Galaxies, I was thinking very seriously about moving away from the Samsung brand and maybe going toward LG or something like that, just because my S2, S3, and S... Or, I'm sorry, my S3 and S4 were really shitty phones. This one, though, I really like it because I could use it as a remote control to control my television and stuff like that. There are some differences between my 5 and my 4. My 4 seemed to have a lot more functionality than what my 5 does. Like, I'm not going to get into a technical spec review or whatever, but... So, yeah, I have an S5. I would like to have an S7 or even the new 8 that's coming out, but we'll see how that goes, because I just recently got this like November, so I have to keep it probably at least a year before I can up to another phone. Let's see, what's the next one? What do I like to do in my spare time? So, in my spare time, I really love to just hang out with my friends and go for coffee. Like, that is one of the most favorite things that I love to do, is just go with a friend or a family member or something like that and just go to a little cafe, get a cup of coffee, relax, and just talk about our day. I have a girlfriend that me and her go out a couple of times a week, and it benefits us both. One, I get out of the house for a little while, and she has adult conversation. So she's a stay-at-home mom, and she takes care of everyone, and she just never really does anything for herself. So that's what I like to do during my spare time, is to go get coffee with friends or family. The other thing that I really like to do is I love to paint. I'm not a great painter, but the painting that I do brings me happiness and it brings me joy. So I will sit there and I will turn on music and just paint until I'm like content, really. So yeah, that's one of the things. What is my middle name? So my middle name is Scott. It was supposed to be Lee, like my father's, making me a junior, but my biological egg carton decided to name me Scott out of spite because she didn't want me to be a junior, and she told me that Scott was the name of a friend of hers that was shot and killed, like, right before I was born. I was like, thank you for putting that on me, I guess. I don't know. Yeah. What was the last thing I purchased? Last thing I purchased was some milk. I know, exciting, right? If I could meet anyone in history, who would it be? That's a really hard question for me, because there's not many historical figures that I'm like gaga over. So as stupid as it sounds, I mean, they're not a historical figure, but I would have loved to have met my great grandparents, the ones who immigrated over from Sweden. Just to, like, know them a little bit and know a little bit more about their particular histories and stuff like that. But as for, like, a actual historical figure, maybe someone that was deep and contemplative, like Plato or someone like that. As long as there wasn't a language barrier, that's who I would probably like to meet. Let's see. What is the first thing you do when you wake up? Go to the bathroom? I don't know. Besides going to the restroom, I always... Well, actually, even before I go to the bathroom, I always roll over and check my phones to see if I had any messages or whatever. And then, depending on how big of an urgency it is for me to actually get up and go to the bathroom, I may check my email and then go. So, yeah, probably TMI right there. Let's see. Am I a saver or am I a spender? So, I'm a little bit of both. Back in the day when I was able to work, my motto was, if I see it, I like it, I want it, I buy it. Now that I am living on an extremely fixed income, my motto is, do I really need it? So, I guess I'm a saver now. I try to save as much money as possible, which is almost impossible, but What was your favorite, your childhood book? Your favorite childhood book? So, I actually have several favorite childhood books. Rikki Tikki Tavi was one of them, The Little Engine That Could, and the other one, I want to say it's like the Seven Chins or Chans or something like that. I just remember that it was a story about a bunch of they were Chinese brothers, and like one could swallow the whole ocean, the other one could overinflate himself, and all these other weird characteristics. As a child, I was always fascinated by like superpowers and stuff like that and superheroes, so I really liked that book. And then there was this other one that I cannot for the life of me remember what the name of it is, but it was another like Japanese Chinese folklore type book, and it revolved around this lady or this family who had a I think it was like a kimono shop or something like that, and they rescued this person, and in order to repay their kindness, the person would make these beautiful, elaborate silk kimonos. And the only stipulation was that the people could not watch while they were being made. So they had to do it in secrecy. And the person said, you know, if as long as you respect my privacy and don't try to spy on me, I will continue to bless you. And so the whole story was that eventually the people who took in this other this person happened to spy on the other person while making a kimono, and turns out that it was a crane who would pluck her feather. Yeah, it was a her. She would pluck her feathers and weave that into silk. So, yeah, that's. Those are a couple of my books. I wish I could remember those names because I'd really like to reread them. What kind of kid were you? Spoiled, rebellious, well-behaved, quiet, obnoxious, etc. So, I think that I was a well-behaved child and that I was quiet for the most part. Now, if you had my sister tell the story, I was demon spawn, but I was one of those push the boundary children also. Like, you told me I couldn't do something, and it's like, well, why? Why can't I do this? If everyone else is doing it, why can't I do it? As I've grown up, I've kind of maintained that same tone, but at the same time, I'm just like, I don't care. You don't want me to do something? Fine, I'm not gonna do it. Unless it's something that I feel strongly about, like if somebody is telling me, well, don't get involved with this or that because of what of reasons or whatever, then I'll try to like, well, no. So, anyways, yeah. I'm going to say that I was a well-behaved child. Even though, actually, talking about it right now, I can remember throwing fits in a store a couple of times. So, I don't know. Well, what was your favorite subject in school? So, growing up in the 90s, it was the dawn of the personal computer, and the internet had just started coming to the public sector. For those of you who don't know, and I'm seriously freaking dating myself here, the internet used to be a military installation that they used to order parts and send secure messages back and forth to each other. It wasn't until the 80s, or till the mid 80s, when people started really figuring out what the internet was and getting on it themselves. So with that, I was really into computers, really into the internet, into robotics and stuff like that. So any class that I could take that had anything to do with computers or computer literacy, operation, repairs, I was all over that. The secondary part of all of that that I was really into was art. So I really got into art and computers. And in the art class that I was taking, we covered so many different aspects of art. One focus throughout the year was on fashion design. And for the longest time there, I thought that I would like to become a fashion designer. I'm really glad that I have kind of stepped away from that idea, because I cannot use a sewing machine, but I can hand stitch. And if I had to mass produce hand stitched items, no. Plus, I have friends who are in the fashion industry who have made it pretty big for themselves, like Michael Costello and stuff like that. So if you don't know who Michael Costello is, look at Project Runway Season 6, and you'll see him. He's like best friends on the show with Mondo Guerrera, and so I'm actually really good friends with Michael. We met because he was dating my best friend at the time, and so I knew Michael before he really got discovered. And so just watching all the behind the scenes stuff that he had to do as a has to do as a fashion designer, I don't have that type of stamina or that desire. So, what was my least favorite subject? Okay, so my least favorite subject in school was math. I was undiagnosed with dyscalculia, which is where you transpose numbers, for the longest time. And back when I was going through school in the 90s, they were just learning about dyscalculia and dyslexia and stuff like that. So for most of my schooling, I was always in like some kind of special needs class. And I hate to make it sound like that, because it sounds like I was developmentally disabled, but I'm not. but they don't, because they didn't understand why I couldn't read certain things or why I had a hard time with mathematics. Well, it was because I was dyslexic and I had dyscalculia. So not only did I transpose the words, I transposed the numbers. And because of that, stuff just really didn't stick all that well. Okay, so this next question is, have I ever been in love? And yeah, I have been. I've actually been in love probably 3 times that I can truthfully say. Yeah, it's kind of a sore subject for me, because even though those people are still in my life, we are not together anymore. So yeah, I'm one of those people that stays friends with their exes. I mean, we were friends before we got together. Why can't we be friends afterwards? So just about everyone that I've ever dated, I'm still friends with. So yeah. Do you believe in soulmates? That's a really tricky question. Also, I do believe that there are at least one or two people in this world that you're meant to be with, that you connect with on such a deep level that you are completely intertwined with one another, and The reason I say that is because I look at my grandparents. They were together almost 57 years when my grandfather passed away. And they were so in sync with one another that they would finish each other's sentences or without even saying anything to each other, the other one would just turn and say, "Yeah, I agree." And it was kind of weird, and I always thought, are my grandparents witches? How are they speaking telepathically or whatever? But no, I do believe that you do have that one or two people in the world that you connect with. I mean, everyone else, yeah, you have a connection with them at some level, but I do believe that you have a soulmate because when you're with that person, it's just like you're complete. So yeah. What are your turnoffs? Okay, so my turnoffs are people who are overly cocky and bitchy for just no reason. Now, there's a difference between bitchy and catty, and there's always a place for both. But if you are one of those people who are trying to live above your station in life, and you're portraying this, like, "Oh, well, I wouldn't do that," type attitude, and I know your struggle and I know your story, that pisses me off. Or like people who think that they're better than other people for absolutely no reason. So I guess cockiness and arrogance really like push my buttons, and are a complete total turn off. And also people who don't have a sense of humor. Like I have a wicked sense of humor. I love to laugh. I'm constantly joking around with people. And so if you don't have a sense of humor and you don't know how to just laugh at yourself and laugh at the world, that really kind of puts me off also. But even then, if I'm attracted to the person, then I get like love blinders or whatever. So, it's really difficult for me because if you follow anything with Zodiac or whatever, I'm both an Aries and a Pisces because I'm like right at the deadline for both. So my birthday is March 16th, and Aries starts March 18th, I believe, or the 20th. So I'm just like right there. So I have dual personalities. I'm both a hopeless romantic and destroy the universe because I chipped a nail or, something like that. So really hard for me to completely like dismiss somebody if I am attracted to them in any way. Who is your favorite athlete? Okay, so with this question, I have to be honest, I don't like sports at all. And you could probably tell, but I couldn't tell you who anyone was or who my favorite sports character would be because I just don't follow sports. Now, on the flip side of that, the only sports that I do like happens to be, and I know that I just said that I don't like sports, but if I have to play a sport, I like baseball, volleyball, swimming, and for whatever reason, I love watching curling. And if you've never heard of curling, go check that shit out on YouTube. It's the most random thing in the universe, but it's my favorite thing to watch during the Winter Olympics. Basically, there are these big granite stones. People slide them down this runway of ice. It's kind of like shuffleboard, I guess. Don't really understand it, but I enjoy the hell out of it. So I'm gonna move past all of the sports questions. Okay, vacation. Where? So, Where was the last place that you went on vacation? So, if you could call it a vacation, a couple of videos ago, I talked about my trip to Portland, Oregon, and so, in the broadest of sense, Portland, Oregon was my last time I went on a vacation. Before that, it was, I went back out to California last summer to go visit my mom and my family, or my friends and family, while I was out there, and stayed for 3 weeks. So, if you want to count the Portland trip as a vacation, cool. If you want to count the California trip as a vacation, cool. What is my favorite drink? So, if we're talking about soda, I love Dr. Pepper. Otherwise, it's like tea or coffee. If we're talking alcoholic drink, I absolutely love Adios Motherfuckers and Long Island iced teas. And then anything fruity. I love the fruity drinks. The sweeter, the fruitier, the better. What is my favorite food? All of the things. No. I would have to say my all-time ultimate favorite food would probably be hamburgers. I love me some hamburgers. Second on that list would be Mexican. And third would be pizza. So yeah. And what really sucks is not even a football field away is one of the best Mexican restaurants in the entire area that I live in. And so every once in a while I'll get a whiff of their food cooking and I'll just be like, oh god, I would kill for some Mexican food right now. Yeah. Are there any foods that I dislike or will not eat? So, I don't have too many foods that I absolutely hate, but there are foods that I will shy away from. Like, they won't be my first choice on the menu. Fish. Now, I love sushi, but I'm allergic to certain types of fish. Like tilapia, I can eat maybe one or two pieces of tilapia before it really wreaks havoc on my system. Salmon, now depending on how the salmon is cooked or cured or whatever, I can eat salmon. If it's just raw salmon, I can only eat like maybe two or three pieces of that. If it's just a regular salmon fillet, I can't eat any of that, which I have no idea why. I can probably get about three spoonfuls in or forkfuls before it makes me sick. But if it's smoked or jerkied, I can eat it. So I don't know. There's clams and oysters, both of which I love. Clams, oysters, and mussels. I love all three of those, but I can't eat them because they cause me to get really sick, and I get vertigo from oysters. Clams make me, like, extremely sick, and mussels do the same exact thing. I can usually tell if I'm going to be able to eat a piece of seafood or fish within the first second of, like, sticking it in my mouth, because there's times where my body craves fish, and then it's like, okay, I can eat fish, but it's only going to be, like, one or two pieces before it makes me sick. So it's really strange, really strange. So I typically steer away from fish, oysters, mussels, clams, you know, that type of stuff. I really don't like cream of wheat. I will eat it, but it's, again, one of those not my first go-to meals. So, yeah. There's that. What is the signature dish that I like to cook? So, I'm a little bit of a kitchen witch. I love cooking. I went through a phase where about a year ago, I just really stockpiled my kitchen with broth and all this other stuff. And I adore and I worship Ina Gardner. She has a television show on the Food Network channel called The Barefoot Contessa. And I used to watch her every day, and I printed out a bunch of her recipes and stuff like that, and so I would try to mimic those. So as for a signature dish, I do a killer pulled pork. I make up my own barbecue sauce and everything else, and I will cook the meat for like an entire day in a slow cooker, and then make up my own barbecue sauce and add that in, and like, oh, it sounds so good. I might actually make that tonight. So yeah, that's my signature dish. What is my favorite pizza topping? So my favorite pizza topping really varies. I am typically one of those people who will order a supreme pizza just because it has typically everything that I want on there. But there's other times where I only want like a Hawaiian pizza. And I've had two versions of Hawaiian pizza. I've had the real Hawaiian pizzas, like from actually there in Hawaii. And over in Hawaii, they put cashews on them, on with the Canadian bacon and the pineapple. And that's good, but when you're biting into something and you hit that hard crunch, it kind of throws you off, so whatever. But so supreme pizzas are Hawaiian. Those are my two favorites. Who is my favorite actor or actress? So I actually have a couple of these. For the longest time there, my most favorite actress was oh shoot. Her first name's Gina, but I can't remember the last part of it. Wow, that sucks. But she was in the long Gina Goodman? That's not right. She was in The Long Kiss Goodnight. She was also in A League of Their Own, and I think she also played like in the West Wing or something like that, or she was some kind of president or something like that. So yeah, I really liked her, and I mean, I don't really have too many actors or actresses that I really like. I mean, there are actors that I will specifically watch a movie just because they're in it. Like James Franco, for instance. Okay, I love him. I think he's hilarious. I like everything that he does. Well, pause. I like most of what he does. Dave Franco, his little brother, I love him. Seth Rogen, I kind of have a love-hate relationship with Seth Rogen. What is another actor that I kind of like? Oh, there's this one dude. He's an English actor, and he played in like Hot Fuzz and Shaun of the Dead and stuff like that. I really like him. Yeah, so sorry, not more forthcoming with that. What was the last movie that I watched? So the last movie that I watched was actually a couple of nights ago, and it was Practical Magic with Sandra Bullock. I love Sandra Bullock. I love Stalker Channing. Nicole Kidman, I can take or leave, but I just absolutely love that movie. Everything about that movie just resonates with me, and I think it's a really good, wholesome family movie. What is the favorite type of music? So my favorite type of music, believe it or not, is actually R&B. I love me some R&B. I'm not like straight up Fitty Wop or anything like that, though I do appreciate old school gangster rap, like 90s gangster rap, Snoop Dogg, Coolio, Ice-T, Ice Cube, all of them. NWA, I really like that genre of music. So my secondary music that I really like is country music. And I'll just put it this way, I love all forms of music. Doesn't matter if it's Tibetan throat singing or Middle Eastern, like, praise chants or whatever. I love all forms of music except for Mexican mariachi music. I do not like that type of music. It's really hard. I can't even explain it. I just really don't care for mariachi. Now, I love Spanish music. And I do not like reggaeton, like Sean John or Sean Paul, whatever the hell his name is, Pitbull, those type of singers. I fucking loathe that music. I don't like it. It makes them sound kind of special when they're singing. So who's your favorite music artist? So my favorite music artists are Madonna. I like Marilyn Manson. I like the Dixie Chicks, Fleetwood Mac, Steely Dan. I like a lot of his stuff. Who else? Michael Jackson, like 80s Michael. Though I do like some of his 90s music. Yeah. Can't really think of too many other people right now. Okay, and here's the last couple of questions. What are you scared of? Honestly, I'm scared to death of fucking coyotes. Like, it bothers the hell out of me whenever I hear coyotes. Even driving in a car and seeing a coyote out in the field will bug the shit out of me. Like, my skin will, like, I'll get the goosebumps and all that other stuff. That actually relates back to when I was a little kid growing up out in the desert. It was the middle of the night. Well, not really the middle of the night, but for me as a little kid, it was the middle of the night. It was like 7:30, 8 o'clock at night. Summer night. It was really, really hot. We had our front door open because our air conditioner had been broken. And I was sitting on the floor by the front door playing, because what little bit of air was coming through came right through our went out the front door. Anyways, I was playing with my toys, and I happened to turn and look, because we had a tree, a ficus tree, that left like really crunchy leaves, and I heard the leaves crunch, and I looked, and I thought it was a dog, but it was a coyote. And it lunged through the screen door to try to get me. Thankfully, the family dog, like, beat the fuck out of it, and it took off. But ever since then, I've had issues with coyotes and stuff like that. What do my parents do for a living? So, when my father was alive, he was a construction worker, and he worked his way up from literally the pits to being a construction supervisor and a water supervisor for the Coachella Valley Water District. And so 90% of Palm Springs, 90% of the Coachella Valley, he put in throughout his 30-year career. So yeah, any part of Palm Springs or that whole little area that was built between 85 and 2002, he probably put it in or inspected it or oversaw its construction. What is the most embarrassing moment that I can recall? So it happens to be I was on my first date with someone and I was wearing flip-flops and I was going up an escalator and talking, trying to be cool and smooth and everything, and my fucking flip-flop got caught up in the escalator and it chewed the whole end of my shoe off, and it actually caused quite a scene because they had to stop the escalator, reverse it so that I could get my shoe out, and it looked like something had just bit. And at the time, I was horrified because I was on like this first time date with this person. It was a crowded shopping mall. Yeah. And yeah, yes. Okay, and so the last question of the night, or well, of this video, is what was your first car? So, technically, my very first car was a Honda Accord LX, and it was a 91, and it was champagne brown, or that, like, champagne peachy color, and it was fully automatic, had a console phone and all this other stuff. But my first car that was like mine that I felt was my first car was actually a 1985 Lincoln Mercury Cougar. It was this big ass land yacht of a beast that I used to name, or I named my car Tawanda after my favorite movie, one of my favorite movies, Fried Green Tomatoes. So yeah. Anyways, I just realized that we're like 42 minutes into this video, so I am sorry. If you have followed through with watching all of this, you are a freaking rock star. I'm sorry. Next time I will try to cut these down a little bit. So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, put them in the comment section below. If you like me doing these Q&A videos, hit the thumbs up and let me know all about that. If you haven't done so already, please hit the subscribe button. Doesn't cost you a thing. But if you love my, if you like my videos or love them, you know, hit the subscribe and then hit the little bell, and then you'll be notified whenever I upload anything. So, in the comment section below, what would you like to see me do next? So, I've gotten a couple of requests for reaction videos. And if that's something that you would like me to start doing more of, put that in the comment section below. And above and beyond that, if you need to get a hold of me, it's you can shoot me an email at hellocupcakeitsme@gmail.com. Follow me on Instagram at Michael Scott Peterson, all one word, S-O-N. And yeah, I will talk to you all soon. Goodbye. Thank you.